Hello everyone, welcome to this video. In this video, we shall see a question from IIT JAM 2020 consisting of 2 marks, and this is a MCQ type question answer. That means only one option here is the correct option. Okay, so let's have a look at the question. The question here is given to be the find the value of triple integral. So this is the triple integral given to you for the function x square y plus 1. Where this volume V is defined by the region and the equations for that particular region, they are given by x square plus y square less than equal to 1, and z varies from the point 0 to 2. So now, in order to calculate here what is this region, so first of all we should have a knowledge about what is this region, what these equations represent exactly. So if you look at these equations closely, you will observe that x square plus y square less than equal to 1 forms a disk, right, having center as the point 0, 0 and radius as equal to r is equal to 1, right? So let's draw this thing. So we have this as the coordinate axis, right? Suppose this is your z axis, this is the x axis, and this is the y axis. So this x square plus y square less than equal to 1 forms a circle centered at 0 and having radius equal to 1. So suppose this point is 1 and this point is equal to 1. So you have a disk something like this, right? So this is your circle, and moreover we cannot just take our region to be just from these equation. We have to look at other equation also, where z is defined to be in between the point 0 to 2. So that means here at the point z is equal to 0, we have a disk of this kind, and suppose this is the point where z is equal to 2. So here also we have the same disk centered at this point having radius as 1 equal to this one, right? So this is the disk, and in between also we have several disks like this which are joined together end to end. So that means we have a cylinder like shape. So that means I can join this point with this point here with a straight line, and this point here with the point here. So this is our cylinder. So basically our region of interest is this whole region, and we are to perform the triple integration of the given function over this region, right? So this is our region. So for this particular region, we are to decide our limits of integration. So that is not directly given to you in the question. So let's have a look here. So we are given the triple integration of the function x square y plus 1. So we have x square y plus 1, and we have dx dy dz. So this integral we have. So that means first of all I am to write the limits for x, then for the limits of y, and then for the limits of z. So for writing the limits for z, now they are pretty simple and they are given to you in the question. All these things are going to remain the same. Here we'll write the limits for x, here we'll write the limits for y, and here we'll write the limits for z. And if you look at the given question, in the given question you have these two equations. So that means the value of z is from the point 0 to the point 2. So we have our limits for z varying from 0 to 2. Now the remaining portion is to calculate the limits for x and y. Now, how can you calculate the limits of x and y? This could be calculated if you take this particular circle, right? This disk-like structure consists of from this disk-like structure, you can very easily calculate what are the limits of your variables x as well as y. So first of all, we wanted to write down the limits for x. So that means whenever you wanted to write down the limits, variable limits for x, so in that case, let me redraw the circle here. Suppose this is your x-axis and this is your y-axis, right? In that case, if I take, if I wanted to change, take the variable limits of x, so that means I will take the horizontal line in this particular case to cover whole of this area. So here the equation for this circle is x square plus y square is equal to 1, right? For the disk it is less than equal to 1, for the circle it is exactly equal to 1. So for this particular disk, when you take the value here, the point where this arrow enters this region and the point where it leaves this region, so that means we are to calculate the value of x from this equation. So when you calculate the value of x, you have x square is equal to 1 minus y square, or in other words, you have the value of x as plus minus square root of 1 minus y square. So you have two values of x, one is this negative value and one is this positive value. So here we will have the negative value of x as equal to minus square root of 1 minus y square, and here at this point we will have the positive value of x as square root of 1 minus y square, right? So we got our limits for x, they are minus 1 minus square root of 1 minus y square to plus square root of 1 minus y square. So these are the limits of x. Now, because we wanted to cover whole of this region, so basically we are to move whole of this arrow to different portions, from here to here to here. So that means we wanted to cover this much portion by moving this arrow in this particular direction. So what are the limits for y here? If you look at, because you know this disk is centered at the point 0 and it has radius 1, so that means this distance is equal to 1 and this distance is also equal to 1. So this point is basically plus 1 and this point is minus 1, right? So we obtain the limits for y, they are equal to minus 1 to the point 1. So this is our integral. So we obtained our limits. Now the next task is to solve this particular integral. Okay, so let's get going. Let's solve this integral. So first of all, we'll solve this much portion, integration with respect to x. So let me write down all the other quantities as such. Integration of the limits of z as such, the limits of y as such, then dy and dz as such. So when you solve, perform this integration with respect to x, you will have y and 1 to be treated as constant. So that means you will have x cubed by 3y plus x, and the limits of x, they now varies from minus square root of 1 minus y square to plus square root of 1 minus y square. So when you solve this quantity, when you substitute the limits here, let me write down these things. So this simply becomes equal to, so you have y by 3 as such, in place of x you will write this thing, so it would be minus 1 minus sorry 1 minus y square square root. Square root means the power 1 by 2, and we have the power 3 as well, so it's power 3 by 2. And moreover, when you substitute the lower limit here, it would be minus of this quantity, right? So we had plus of this same quantity, so it would be 2 times of this quantity. And when you substitute the limits here, it would be again 2 times for the quantity square root of 1 minus y square. So this is what you have here. Now the next step is to perform the integration with respect to y. So how can you perform the integration over here with respect to y? So here what we'll do, we'll separate out these terms first. So it would become integration z varying from 0 to 2, right? Y varying from minus 1 to 1, and the first term y by 3, in fact 2y by 3, and we have 1 minus y square raised to power 3 by 2 dy dz. So this is our first term, and the second term we had z is equal to 0 to 2, y varies from minus 1 to 1, right? And you have the value 2 square root of 1 minus y square dy dz. Now we have to solve these integrals. If you look at your integral closely over here, now this is an odd function. Why? Because in place of y, so the function here is f of y defined to be 2 by 3y, 1 minus y square raised to power 3 by 2. So instead of y, if you substitute minus y, so you will have minus 2y by 3, and here you have minus y square raised to power 3 by 2. So this is equal to minus f of y. So this is an odd function here. So if this is an odd function, its integration is simply equal to 0, right? And for this particular quantity, we'll perform the integration. So we have 0 plus, for this quantity, it would be, we can take out two outside, and the integration of, you have this formula, integration of square root of a square minus x square dx, that is equal to x by 2 square root of 1 minus x square plus a square by 2 sine inverse x upon a. So this is the formula. So we'll use this formula here. So it would be equal to 2, and we have y by 2 square root of 1 minus y square plus a here is 1, so we have 1 by 2 sine inverse of y, and the limits here vary for y from minus 1 to 1, and the integration with respect to z as such, right? So we have this quantity. So when you solve this one, you will be getting 0 plus 2, and when you substitute the limits for y, this integration with respect to z would be as such. When you substitute the value of y as 1, you have 1 by 2. This 1 minus 1, this would become 0. And when you substitute the lower limit here, this would be minus 1 by 2, 1 minus minus 1 square root, right? This quantity plus 1 by 2, the value of sine inverse of the upper limit 1 minus sine inverse the lower limit as 1. So you have whole of this quantity over here. Okay, so we have two integration z varying from 0 to 2. Now this quantity 1 minus 1 is 0, this quantity 1 minus 1 is 0. So we have 1 by 2 sine inverse of 1 minus sine inverse of minus 1 dz. And what is sine inverse of 1? It is equal to pi by 2. So, and moreover, this 1 by 2 and 2 get cancels out here. So, we have the value here. Integration with respect to the limit z varying from 0 to 2. Sine inverse of 1 is pi by 2. And sine inverse of minus 1 is equal to minus pi by 2. So we have pi by 2 plus pi by 2, that is equal to pi. So integration z varying from 0 to 2 pi dz, that is equal to pi into z. The limits for z vary from 0 to 2. So this quantity is equal to pi 2 minus 0. So we have the answer as 2 pi. So our final answer here is equal to 2 pi. So let's have a look at our options. Our answer, final answer, is the option B. So I hope you understood this question very well. Well, that is it for this video. Thank you for watching.